So my name is Gary Hall Jr. I'm a 3-time Olympian and 10-time Olympic medalist. And I also have type 1 diabetes. I was almost 2 years old when my father won the bronze medal in 1976.
I just immediately felt a sense of pride. I picked up Gary and carried him around the pool deck, and he walked with me back to the awards ceremony.
That was my first Olympic experience.
Little did I know then that that little 2-year-old was going to grow up to be one of the fastest swimmers in the world.
Having a father that was a successful Olympic swimmer, being around the swimming pool was always a second home to me. I was swimming before I could walk, but never took it seriously, and there wasn't a whole lot of pressure on me to kind of follow in his footsteps, and I appreciate that he didn't put that type of pressure on me. His only and best advice that he ever gave me was go out and have fun. I liked having a guy next to me that I was trying to beat, and it was a great outlet for that competitive spirit that I was starting to develop at that time. I qualified for the 96 Olympics in both the 50 and the 100 meter freestyle, and it also put me on a couple of relays.
He's gonna have the gold as well, and the Americans pull it off in Olympic record time.
I was in between the 96 and 2000 Olympics, and I would just start shaking uncontrollably in swim practice. I'd have to pull myself out of the water, and I was weak and dizzy, and I'd have to drink a lot of Gatorade. I figured that there was something probably wrong.
And he was just feeling terrible, so we took him down to the doctor, and he said, well, let's do some tests, and he drew some blood. He looked at the strip, he said, Gary's got diabetes.
I remember hearing the word diabetes in the doctor's office when I was diagnosed, and the exhale, I remember it so clearly. It was more than just breath leaving my body. I knew it was serious.
Why did this kid, this world-class athlete, why did he get diabetes? And I remember Gary looked up and he said, you know, what does this do for my swimming career? And the doctor said, you'll never be able to compete at a world-class level again.
And I was told that day by not one but two doctors, the diagnosing doctor and later an endocrinologist, that my swimming career would be over.
And I just remember Gary getting this really, really depressed look on his face, like, how can this be?
I was upset, angry, and confused.
Even the parents or the family members can forget about it, but the person that has the disease has to remember it every single day of his life.
I ended up kind of taking off against doctor's orders and taking this vacation that I needed, took as much information with me as possible, and read up on what diabetes was. And during that time, my father had sought out a different endocrinologist that was supportive. That little bit of encouragement was enough to give me a reason to try. At that point, I wasn't sure that I could be as fast as I was before I was diagnosed with diabetes. There was struggles. Anybody that has diabetes, it's gonna struggle with it.
I knew it would have to, you know, entail huge changes for him. And so it was a definite complete lifestyle change to learn about the risks of the disease, but also how to take care of himself and deal with the amount of food and nutrition that he needed to keep up the training that he wanted to do.
I had no idea how a slice of pizza was going to affect my blood sugar levels. I had to constantly make changes through this time of trial and error, but I was able to do it.
You feel proud of your son, you feel proud of what he overcame, and to be told by renowned physicians that he never will swim at that level again, and then to prove them wrong, it just made me feel this kid is something really special.
I went to the Olympic Games in 2004, defended the title as world's fastest man in the 50 freestyle.
Thank you.
Now I have 10 Olympic medals, and the majority of them were won with diabetes. I've decided to give the 2008 Olympics to be held in Beijing a try. I'm still really fit, swimming fast, do my best to keep the diabetes under control. I still need to test as often as I did at the beginning. We do a lot of different stuff. We do weight training. I really like boxing as a dry land activity. We'll take the boat out and strap on a pair of fins and a mask.
The hardest part is getting all this stuff on.
We'll dive down between 30 to 50 feet. It's great exercise. Builds the lungs and the legs. If you take care of this, the sky's the limit. Diabetes doesn't have to stand between you and your dream.